So once upon a time, there were two happy schoolboys called James and Dan. And they had a great little line in after-school detection, finding missing bikes, squealing on smokers, bribing them for fags, that sort of thing. I love my life. Don't you love your life, Dan?
Yes, James. I'm very fond of my teenage life. We are abundant in pocket money. Splendid.
Then one day, a new girl moves into town and sits behind James and Dan in history class.
Good day, boys. My name's Natalie Blaise. I have no friends in this new town and I'm a tomboy. Do you guys want to hang out?
But Natalie, we don't hang around with girls, for we are not into discos and shifting. We are into sleuthing and detective work.
Oh, wow. That sounds great. Can I join you?
Yes. All right. Let us be friends.
Yes, Natalie. You seem like a nice girl.
So they all became the best of friends and got up to all sorts of adventure.
Oh, James. Oh, Natalie. I do so love our picnics.
And on this went for years, with Dan and James fostering in young Natalie a love of the sleuthing arts. Then...
I'm much better than James and Dan, so I'll start changing my clothes and being all cool, and then I'll start putting on my poisonous kissing lips on James and Dan at the same time and not tell them. James, would you like to be my boyfriend?
Yes, Natalie. Please let's do that. You are nice.
Hey, Dan, would you like to be my boyfriend?
Gulp. Why, yes, Natalie, that would be splendid.
And then James and Dan discovered they were both going out with Natalie, and they got in a fight after school, and Dan punched James.
You threw the first punch, James.
It's not right.
I am hurt and betrayed. We shall get horrible revenge on Natalie.
Whatever about that. And then Natalie made her name as a detective, and age 20 was recruited by Interpol to be their liaison officer to Ireland. And James and Dan haven't seen her in nearly 10 years.
We got our own office and an aisle, and we're very happy, and will never be turned on again.
The end.
And that's why she's a bitch.
Andrew, it's been so long since you've written to me. Have they given you more hours in the diamond mine? It's not because of the improving economy in Botswana, is it? If it keeps improving, perhaps I shall move over. Do you need more private detectives in Botswana? Anyway, all is bad with me since Natalie returned to town. She's that force of utter evil I often allude to. Our business has been shut down due to criminal association, and I fear Natalie's Pinkerton mob want to rape our lives. Wait. Did you hear that, Andrew? Never mind. These blasted Pinkertons have rattled me. But most of all, I don't know what to do about Isabel. I fear how much I'll hurt her if I tell her what her architect boyfriend Tom Moriarty has been up to. But yet, she should know. And of course, my own feelings. Should I confess to her? Should I tell her how I really feel?
Can you finish that letter in your own house?
I fear the Pinkertons know where I live. So does Jane.
We should probably just stay in Tennyson's. I'm sure he won't mind.
You do know I have a couch downstairs.
Shh. It's safer this way.
Did my breadcrumb trail work?
No, the birds ate it.
Jackdaws?
I'm not sure.
Cursed avian scourge.
Why are you dressed like that?
To avoid drawing the Pinkertons' attentions.
You look just like Jim.
What?
It's a Sherlock Holmes costume.
Oh.
Look, Isabel. Mm-hmm. There's a reason for this subterfuge.
Yes?
You know how you dislike Natalie Blaise?
What?
Natalie Blaise.
What?
Natalie Blaise!
Well, Dan, it's all in the past now.
Isabel, she's back. She's back from the past into the future, our present.
But she's home. She's the one trying to put you out of business.
Yes. She won't rest until me and James are unemployed or disabled or have a comprehensive fall.
Well, we'll just have to ignore her if we pass her on the street. I'll avoid all eye contact, and if I get the opportunity to walk behind her, I'll step on her heels.
Yes, yes.
No. No, that's mean.
No, Isabel, it's warranted. She urinated on your tea set, and she spat on your back when you weren't looking.
Yes, Dan, well, that's all in the past now. Bullies aren't worthy of our attentions. I shan't rise to it. I'm better than that.
Yes, you are. Your academic boyfriend, Tom Rarity, is working for Natalie. He was in the car with her.
What?
Damn it!
After you last visited, I found blueprints for an underground water feature in some old building.
Good God. A lair.
I trusted him, Dan. I told him all the stories about that woman. He knows. And everything was going so well. And then she came along. And I bet she couldn't resist him.
Isabel. I haven't seen you cry like this since I got that breakup letter from Bobby Blanco in 6 years. That was most distressing.
How do you know about that letter?
I think I wrote it.
Why?
Well, the buffoonish oaf, he didn't have a poetic word in his head. He asked me to write his love letters.
It was you all along? Since I was 14? Earlier?
Andrew, give me strength. I've had love for you for, well, mostly legal years.
Some friend you are, Dan McGrain.
Isabel!
Why were you following Tom?
Mustache envy. Ow! Ow! Isabel! Isabel! Don't call the police! Isabel!
Isabel! Isabel! Isabel!
Isabel! There you are!
Don't you dare! There you are, me, Tom!
Isabel, my dear, what's the matter?
You've been working for her, haven't you?
Her? Who? I know lots of women, Isabel. Lots.
Natalie Blaise. You knew how much of a bully she was. You were well aware of how she'd pee in my tea and spit behind my back.
Isabel, calm down. That was all a long time ago. Past tense. It's just business, baby.
Don't you baby me, Tom.
I could have told you, sure. But I didn't want to stress you out with your big performance coming up. And the money. We'll be rich. You can finally open your ballet school and I can finally build that walk-in wardrobe I've always wanted.
Oh, keep your damn money. If it wasn't for Dan, the truth may never have come out.
McGrain.
We're through, Tom. I simply cannot be with a man who spends his life fibbing left, right and centre. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to go practice for my performance. Don't even try grabbing me or spinning me or...
What would you do without me, Isabel? Move out of my boudoir? Go to Moscow without a gentleman to ward off rapists? Would you really let a catch like me go?
Yes, I would. Natalie Blaise is bad news, Tom. Enjoy life under her thumb. Goodbye!
Curse you, Dan McGrain. I will be the architect of your downfall!
I'll say goodbye to love. No one ever cared
should live or die. Time and time again, the chance for love has passed me by, and all I know.
You did not listen to my Carpenter CD either.
Tennyson, make the tea. Yes, Niall, make some of your splendid tea, for we are far too lazy to fill a kettle and press a switch. Hey, McGrain, let's smoke lots of cigarettes. Splendid, James. But before we do, why don't we dress Niall up as a woman again, or have him stalk someone at a ridiculous hour of the morning? Why the hell not? Maybe he'll get the shit kicked out of him again. Who knows? Who cares?
Hello, Niall. I am Natalie Blaise, and I'd like to hire you. Sure, I can pay you with real money, but I might be as bad as Hitler if what Vultour and McGrain say is true.
Don't do it, Niall. Loyalty and trust. We're your friends.
Friends.
Is that tea made yet?
So, what do you think?
I think those puppets look savage. Did those detective lads make them? The lads staying here.
Niall, I have to be honest. Personally, I would walk straight up to them, put on my bravest face and say, Dan McGrain, answer my calls, you fucking shit.
What material did he use to make that jacket? Is that velvet or is it felt? Here, give us a look. Some craftsmanship. Ah, velvet. Savage. Do you reckon they could do one up for me? I could bring it out my trawler. Gets fierce lonely sometimes.
Niall, I think you should definitely, definitely join the Pinkertons. Do you know why?
Why?
Because Dan McGrain is a fucking bastard.
Look at those lusty infants. Reminds me of us before real life kicked us in the balls. McGrain? McGrain?
What are you doing on my turf?
Ah, there she is. Just the girl we were looking for.
Yeah, what you want to muck to me tits likes?
We've got reason to believe that the Pinkertons are trying to get to our colleagues. They've already tried to lure little Tennyson with their job candy.
Here, take a flyer.
This is Shane and Nicky Hardy. They're fairly fucking useless, but I'm knocking them into detective shape.
Hey lads, do you hear they want to watch Sherlock Holmes and Watson when they went camping?
Congratulations on your new job, but shut up.
Here, can you buy me a few cans from the offie?
If I find them first batch of flyers chucked in the bin somewhere, I will break your fucking legs. Do you hear me?
Yeah, Janine.
Sorry, Janine.
Lads, I don't know why you're so hung up in them Pinkerton benders anyway. There's room for three of us in this town.
Aww, she thinks she's competition, setting up her own little detective agency. Aww.
I'm fucking serious, likes. I'm gunning for number two in this town, so you better be on your guard. Heard you got closed down for hanging around with stoners. Well, do you know what? I've got my own drug testing policy. It's called this. Game fucking on. Lol.
Ruthless female ambition. Do you think Janine could go to the dark side like Natalie?
Natalie?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. It's just like us all those years ago. Running and laughing and solving.
Are people going to get hurt, James? Are we responsible for what she became?
No, McGrain. It was always in her.
She's a monster, isn't she, James?
Yes, McGrain. She's a monster.
Soldier, got any change?
Where's Street? Who are you? What's going on?
I'm Hamish Lane. This is my turf. Street's gotten underground, so I'm taking over his turf. I'm the new informant in this turf. Got any change?
Half tree. Why is Street gone underground?
Pinkertons have put the shits and willies up everyone. You can't walk with all the shit and willies this up.
Why are the Pinkertons attacking people?
I hear there's something personal with them boys, but they got a finger in every cake. They're in with the guards, they're in with the council, photo opportunities with the mayor, free cake, that sort of shite. Got any change?
Buy your own cake. Are you really wheelchair bound?
Aye. I used to pretend to be in a wheelchair and then one day I fell out of my wheelchair rolled over my legs and now I'm in a wheelchair. Got any change?
Ah, there he is. Evening, Tennyson. Somebody jammed this tape into your letterbox this afternoon.
Where did the apple tart come from?
Your mother sent it. We also opened your mail in case there was any threatening material.
We can never be too careful.
No. Right, here's the bastard.
All right, dicks. Happy? Are you happy? You beat me up, and you mess with me hair, and you made the Pinkertons really mad at me. She only wants Vultour and McGrain. And everyone else associated with she is getting a knacker's thumped off him. Come out of hiding and face the music so Jack Street can get back on his turf. Do it now, before this gets any worser. You have been warned. This tape will self-destruct after me under 10 school hurling final. I wasn't able to tape over all of it. On, but fuck it!
Good lord. What do you think of that?
I can't believe he used to play hurling.
Right. We'll need some time to think this over. Isabel's performance starts at 8. Let's get our disguises on. Get to the theatre.
No, I think I'll stay and watch this. Yeah, me too. Why float Isabel for me?
To the ballot, Dan. Do you think I'm not interested in the ballot or something?
Look, it's pronounced ballet. Jane, you gotta help me. Isabel, she's...
I don't want to hear about fucking Isabel. I want to hear about why you've been ignoring me. It's not my fault your business got shut down, okay? You can't project all your anger onto me just because I do my job professionally.
What, can you be a professional vanguarder now and help me find someone who was kidnapped?
When are you gonna start treating me like a fucking lady?
Well, when you start acting like... Hey. Right now, dear. Right now.
That's all you had to say. So is my little unemployed man gonna stay at mine tonight? I fix my bed.
Oh, no, I have to help your brother Niall shave.
Oh, you men. Always shaving.
Why would Natalie kidnap Isabel? Let's just ring her and sort this out.
So what? So Moriarty can take the fall for it. See, this is what she does, Tennyson. Gets others to do her dirty work. Like that time she made us clean her bastard dog's kennel. With one glove each.
You wear my jumper?
I'm tinted.
Oh yeah. Class.
Hello?
I have information about Isabel Vultour. Meet me on Chandler Hill. Bring Tatoes. Do not let anyone follow you. Call me Deep Throat.
That was hardly a wrong number, was it?
I am Deep Throat.
How are you doing, lads? What do you think of me little voice thing? Ripped it out of the little brother's Halloween mask there. Ah, class. Shift over.
Oh. Why do you call yourself Deep Throat?
Oh, for the love of Christ.
Oh, yeah. Anyway, lads, here's the Jack and I. I was talking to a drunk Pinkerton school the other night in the Ten Bells. Apparently they've taken hostage some ballerina, honey. Keeping her down in the old brewery cellar. Oh, yeah.
And?
From 7 a.m. tomorrow morning.
7 a.m. in the morning?
Yeah.
Fuck. All right. Cheers for that, Matt. Information like that is much appreciated at a time like this.
Sure, yeah. No problem. Anything I can do to help. The whole day. Bastard shoved me woman's head down the jacks. Beat me with a wooden cock. Times are hard around here. I've been sleeping rough the last few nights, so.
Well, can Matt stay with us?
Nope. Sorry.
Hi, fair enough.
Scarecrow. And Tom was right, Dan. That really is a pathetic little moustache.
Stop it! Your bullying won't work anymore.
Yes, it will.
No, it won't.
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 Yes, it will. Crossies, no comebacks.
Bollocks.
What have you done with Isabel?
Very worried about Isabel. Aren't we, Dan?
Well, yes, she might be hurt.
Don't worry, she's in slightly capable hands.
Do you like me tie? It's pink.
Turncoats. I am surrounded by turncoats.
Jesus! Look, I'm sorry, lads. I just needed the sponsor you to pay off me student loan. Plus, I got a bird pregnant as well.
You set us up, Matt. Shame on you.
I had to! I can't go on earning minimum wage!
Fuck's sake.
Matthew works for me now. Don't you, Matthew? Soon, everyone's going to work for me. Oh, hello, Niall Tennyson. So nice to meet you in the flesh.
You should wash your hand now, Niall, in case you get typhoid, or bubonic plague,
or the clap.
I'm the one who washed my hands of you two chumps when I left.
Well, Natalie, if you're so successful and so
then
high in my...
What? He's a bender, he admitted it. Jim's a bender, everyone.
Yeah, well, at least I'm not a bitch.
I know you are, but what am I, Jim?
A bitch. I said you're a bitch.
I know you are, but what is she?
A bitch. She's a bitch.
I know you are, Dan, but what am I?
You're a lousy, no-good, friend-stealing bitch.
I know she isn't, Jim, but what are you?
A little bender.
Your mother's a whore!
I'm sorry for calling your mother a whore, but...
But fuck it! You kidnapped my sister and you're trying to run us out of business!
I'm not trying to run you out of business, boys. I only want want to prove that you'll be useless on your own. Like you'll be useless without Niall, and like you are useless without me.
Let's not drag me into all this now.
Yeah, you leave our Niall alone, and you take your gang of thugs and bruisers and smarmy architects and piss off out of our town.
Excuse me? Thugs and bruisers?
He killed a prostitute!
Yeah, the mayor got some tart stuff, so we were called in to clean up the mess.
He was trying to strangle loads of them!
It was a cover-up. People found out about it.
That's when I thought, this town needs a better class of detective, and I'm gonna give it to them. And fuck it, I said I'd screw with you guys, you know, birds and stones and all that.
You planted that girl where we'd find her?
Yep, and since you were so good at getting evicted, I'd give you a little nudge. Who knew that Ned Savage was such an efficient little warden? But still, we had our scapegoat in Jack Street. Ned didn't like us dumping, but where is he now, huh? But then you fuckheads had to get caught up with that stupid stoner and got yourself shut down. Now all I have to do is clean up the mess.
Why did you get him to attack me?
I punch randomers. What are you gonna do?
Jim, Dan, you know what I want. How about you tell Niall what I really want?
It's nothing.
I don't want.
Nothing at all.
You get me what I want, and you apologize for what you fucking dickheads did to me, and then we can see if we can sort something out.
It's your fault Isabel is suffering. McGrain.
No, it's not. It's yours. You kidnapped her.
What if we don't give you what you want?
I don't know. I'll punch her in the mouth. Cut off her hair, break her legs, whatever I feel like doing. Oh, heard from Andrew recently, Dan.
Beast! Where is he?
I don't know, fucking Morocco or whatever country you found me in. But I have been intercepting your mail. Shall I read a letter? Dear Andrew, I fear I can no longer conceal my love for Isabel. It shall explode out of me like a blossoming rose. It was always obvious, though, since we were kids. Wasn't it, Jim?
You fancy my sister?
Oh, James, eh?
Why didn't you say anything? You should have asked her out.
What?
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 Yeah, instead of rubbing my swanky hole here. You would have been such a nice couple. We should, your little hats and everything.
That's what I said. Enough! I don't care, she's tied to a fucking plastic chair and she's not gonna get off it till I get what I fucking want. Understood? And Niall, if you think I'm being unprofessional or evil, I'm not. Sometimes to survive in this business, you have to act unprofessional in order to deal with unprofessional people, like these retards. My offer still stands. Jim, Dan, it's been so lovely seeing you after all this time. I'm going for a bagel. See you fuckheads later. Matthew!
Apologies again, lads. You know, she cracks her head whip, doesn't she? Anyway, if you want any lawyer stuff rented on you, I'll give us a share at the weekends. Actually, don't. She'll probably fire me if she sees me with you, so. See you later, lads! Sound out!
I can't believe how childish that was.
Are we allowed to follow ye?
What has Natalie wanted from me for so long?
She wanted us to have a threesome with her.
And
we wouldn't. And then she got mad.
And that's what she wants now?
Mm-hmm. Yes. That's her ultimatum.
That's disgusting! It's completely unreasonable. No, you can't do that. We have to find Isabel and release her. Threesomes.
Thank you.
well love's own palace, a palace of dreams come true. Now that we're through, I bear no malice, though we've called it a day. All I can say is thanks for all the lovely delight I've found in your embrace. I'm thankful, though I know it's ending all too soon. And thanks for unforgettable nights I never can replace, and memories that linger like a haunting tune. It is better to have loved you dear and lost than never to have loved at all. Yes, it's better, for no matter what the cost, I held the world in sway. I never for a day. And thanks again for taking me on the road to paradise. We lost our way, still I must convey my thanks. It is better to have loved you dear and lost than never to have loved at all. Yes, it's better, for no matter what the cost, I held the world in sway, an emperor for a day. And thanks again for taking me on the road to paradise. We lost our way, but still I must convey my thanks.